If he isn't here, that's fine. I'm gonna send him an email that his replay got done. And we'll send him the link of the YouTube video. But for now, it could still be useful for others. So it's gonna be on Infernal Shrines. Bongdok is the Sonya player. And the draft is Jaina, Sonya, Ragnaros, Murden, Lucio. Against Artanis, Nazebo, Lili, Falstad, and Nuburak. You've got spell damage, mostly spell damage, mostly spell damage against Anubarak, so he is difficult to kill. Now we count your giant killer. You have no giant killers. That means that Anubarak is going to be very difficult to defeat. The battle begins. And also Artanis. Anubarak has spell armor that makes him even harder. Artanis can be killed if he's isolated because he is somewhat vulnerable to chill and slow. But generally, although they have double warrior, and this is the hard part, you cannot really kill their warriors unless they're out of position. You should not focus them like a Leoric Tychus team would. As for their healer is partial healing, partial damage mitigation with blind. As such, I'm just going to start it from the beginning again. As such, it is best to... No, sorry, that's not the sentence I wanted to make. Whoa! My heroes just crashed. Okay, there we go. Yeah, so their healer is good against auto attack damage with blinds. Now, luckily for you, you don't rely on auto attacks too much. So Lili is not the perfect healer for them. Finally, Nazebo is a late game monster. So is Sonya. Whereas Rag, Mira, Lucio, Jaina are pretty consistent throughout the game. Artanis also is really good late game, and so is Lili. I would say they have a slightly better draft than you. Now let's talk about wave clear and objective control. You have Sonya, Rag, Jaina, great splash damage. Lucio has almost no damage. Murden can spec into it. Whereas Artanis is so-so, Nazebo is pretty okay, Lili is weak, Falstad is pretty good, and Nuburak is pretty okay. You have better objective control. Your late game is similar, and your teamfight seems difficult and is mostly revolving around blowing someone up who's out of position.
Greetings, friend.
As for your role, Sonya, you should play it safe until you get to... late game, she is a late game monster. Also, you can do yourself a big favor with Sonya because you're a late game, pretty good hero, is not to do the 5v5 parties in the middle. By the way, if you're wondering, this league is Silver. He's from Silver League, and he's looking to promote to Gold. I think you can do yourself a favor not to join the 5v5 brawls. Sonya is a really good solo laner, and if you go to the 5v5s, you can either die. You can drop really low HP, which doesn't allow you to properly lane anymore. You're taking archer damage. Gives you fury, but it also gives you needless poke loss. My recommendation as Sonya is just to immediately go to the top gate here. Just to show I will not be part of some kind of 5v5 man party. Now let's talk about what you're doing in lane. You are choosing to push the lane as fast as you can. And again, like we always get to laning when we evaluate replays. We need to talk about what does it do for you to push the lane as fast as you can. So there's a number of options. You can passively soak. So you just stand mounted in range of minions that die. It will give you XP if you're close enough. It will mean that the minion waves clash right here. If you do that, if he does the same, if he pushes the lane, the minion wave will clash anywhere from here all the way to here. Towers can help. You can get structural damage on your own structures and you can lose ammunition. But anytime your allies rotate up, their hero is going to be extended on your side, which makes it really easy for your teammates to do a pincer movement. Come from the right, you come from the left, and you can get a kill. Likewise, you can suffer the same fate if you push hard. So you need to have your eyes on the minimap at all times when you're 1v1. There's two people currently missing, and you just lost someone recently, and there's two people hearthstoning. This means that the two people that are missing, which in this case is Artanis and Falstad, could be on you. Now, if Artanis came from here and he flipped you in, Falstad flies behind you, the chances are pretty good that you die. And because you don't know where they are, that is a risk you take when you push the lane hard. Oh, the green screen is still showing? Okay. Where is it? Really? No. But I can just lower it a bit. There. So now let's talk about what you can gain out of pushing the lane. You can get structural damage, or you can deplete his ammo. And if you push the lane fast, you can mount up, join another lane, and be a ganker. And then you make it back on time to your own lane to soak the next wave of XP. So let's see what you do when you get the final minions. At this moment, you have a few options. You can wait for 9 seconds at the objective. You can start hitting an Uberak or the towers. Or you can rotate to another lane and set up a surprise gank. If you are going to go here, I would just stay mounted in this bush. So you attack an Oop, but you don't know if you're getting engaged upon. And also, because the objective is at the top, and you are solo at the top, and you know your teammates are far, the chances that you are going to be against multiple enemies are fairly high, because everyone is going to get drawn to the top. You don't get punished, but that doesn't make you right. Nonetheless, you make it here with full fury, it's great. Fast forward a bit. Talk about your talent choice. You have block against Artanis Falstad. It's a great choice. You're doing the objective, and I feel like you're tunnel visualing on it. And it's not bad per se, but I feel like if you had gone with your team a bit earlier, some kills could have been possible. This is where you whirlwind. This is where you whirlwind and go through them. Don't underestimate the power, like, you walked back and then you whirlwind and you walk away. Don't underestimate the whirlwind of Sonya to get massive heals while whirlwinding on several heroes. There is no way you would have died, and you would have done so much damage and disruption. You spear an Uberak, you chase him, you slam him. And you whirlwind on only Falstad. I would have loved you to zone out the backline with whirlwind. Look at them. They are now able to re-engage on your team because you single target whirlwind. So I think it would have been lovely if you whirlwind right here, get a lot of healing and damage on them, and prevent them from engaging on your team. Finally, because of your positioning, because you didn't stay with your team and whirlwind back, you also died. Even though you got the objective, it's valueless because you can't push with it. You're also down in XP because they laned for longer. So if you had saved yourself, maybe your teammates, maybe you get kills as well. So I would say slightly more focus on the team fight during the entire phase of the objective. It is nice that you got the objective, but I don't think it was close. So you could have always got it later after finishing more team fight. Jaina! Oh my god, he literally meleeed the wall. Got zombied, he's lucky to get away. Now you start camps, it's great. You also took Hurricane, which is a great choice here. Not for the root removal, they don't have root. And they do have some slows potentially. That's nice. But also just for the CDR. Sonya, by the way, is a great hero against Nazebo because you can just whirlwind through the zombie wall and get a lot of healing. Against a single target hero, don't whirlwind. Auto attack, slam. Auto attack twice, slam once. Auto attack twice, slam once. And that's what you were doing now, a little bit late. He also body blocked Rag, so he died. Okay. Two warriors do not have kill pressure against three heroes, whether they are support, assassin, specialist, or warrior. So whatever Muradin is doing is doomed to fail. You and him, you can't get kills here. They have double warrior support. And you see that the rest is here and you just lost someone. So it's very important for you to ping Muradin back. I know he's not your brother, but it's solo queue hero league. But this is where you ping him back and you say, whatever happens next is not my responsibility. It's yours. So you walk away. Instead, you follow him because you have sympathy for him. And you're probably gonna die. And it's all debated by Muradin. Completely pointless, useless, unproductive. Yeah, true, true. And you don't have to feel douchey about it for recognizing that. In fact, although you are right, this is probably going to antagonize Muradin. His shame is probably already complete. And so by saying it, I know it's hard to resist. I fail often in this as well. But he's probably just going to stand still and type or just get upset a bit, whatever. Let your pings speak for you. Ping back twice or once. If he doesn't listen, ping again. That's all you can do. The rest is up to him. You go to the objective again. Nice push here. Okay, you have a talent choice. Muradin had a talent choice, so do you. You are going to choose Poison Spear. The alternatives are Ferocious Healing and Follow Through. Given your build, I think it's okay, probably. Many thanks, healer. Make sure to fight at the top left, so that, or bottom left, so that Rag can reach it all. Don't go too far up. Look, this is the border. Nice. Auto attack and slam Nazivo. Good. Okay. At this point, what you want to do, auto attack and slam Lily once, and then whirlwind through her to go to Anubarak. You get the zombies, you get both of them. But you immediately whirlwind. It's not too bad. But you're still very objective focused, you see? You are a full life Sonya warrior. They're all half life. And you're still thinking, let's get the objective. You will guaranteed get the objective later if you kill them first. But if you get the objective first and ignore them, your allies can die and they don't die. And that is a shame, because they overextended hard and you didn't min-max to punish them. Also, there's Impaler's pushing. You're down a level and you've got the objective. Great. But unless you can get a 5-man push all the way to their keep wall, it's best to think about the long term and put one person in the solo lane to soak. Lucio does it because he knows it should be done. He is the most aware of this necessity. But because he's support, he can't do it. And you're not doing it, although you and Rag are the best solo laners. And Jaina is the best wave clear. So if no one else does it, you should. Now let's talk about the three of you who should do it in an ideal world. Rag can poke over the wall, so can Jaina, you can't. The Punisher's gonna go over the wall, so it should be you. So if anything, I would say your decision making could be better. Look, you can't follow up on it because you're a melee. You could have cleared this, get all the XP, and get level 9. Then whatever you get here is bonus. Now I fear that despite a very good push, you guys will barely get more XP than them. You're also being too frugal, too safe. You are Sonya. They have no giant killer yet. They don't have Nazebo level 20 yet. You've got a Punisher. He's going to join you soon. You've got three very tanky frontliners with a support that can save you with speed or healing. And I see you moving back frequently. Spear, auto attack, slam, whirlwind through them. And you immediately whirlwind through them, which not only gets you initially cancelled, but you also lack DPS. Whirlwind is a great healing mobility talent that does some damage, but slam is your major damage. Auto attack and slam, and Anubarak is right in front of you. Instead, you whirlwind to Artanas, you cancel it in half a second, and you auto attack him once. Whirlwind costs a lot of fury, 40, which is 40%. Nice spear, but you don't finish him, which is a damn shame. Yeah. Could have min-maxed a lot better, and also your ammunition is gone, and so on. But it's okay to push together with your team, but you definitely could have had a couple of hero kills there. And now, this is probably where you think I'm gonna get an impaler, right? But if Merlin goes to the camp, maybe everyone should go.
These mercenaries could be of use to us.
But it's only the three of you, so I would just go back. Ping back, though. You went leap! Considering 100% of their team is sustained damage, Wrath of the Berserker is OP as hell. It gives you 40% bonus damage. Leap does have an interrupt on Jugs, which is great. And maybe you took it for this reason. But you can already see that this is probably going to be a late game because you both have double warrior. And it's Infernal Shrines. It always goes to the late game. And this is what makes Sonya really OP. Not Leap, but Wrath. That's a very nice Leap. I mean, I'm not going to deny that. And I guess he got it for Ravenous as well. So it's going to work out. I'm not going to talk about it again. I think Wrath would be a lot better here. But let's just labor under the assumption that you made the right choice. Auto attack, slam. Auto attack. That's fine. Okay. You steal camp. Half a level up. You go up. That's good. Keep an eye on the minimap. Okay, they're gone. We saw four people here. It's turned to Fog of War. So you need to mount up right now and leave. Even if you didn't see where they all were, the fact that there is one, a shaman camp here, two, the objective is at top, raises the likelihood that they're going to come to top to 95%, even if you weren't there, even if you weren't showing. So your staying here is extremely treacherous. And not only that, but you're going through the bush that they're most likely at. You deserve to die, to be honest. You live, but it forces your team to do very awkward moves. And you die. So I would say that's your fault, Jaina dead. And it's okay to make these mistakes. I make them all the time. It's so easy to analyze a replay and to see this. Of course, the goal here is to teach what I can. Oh. Ouch. It's good, going through the minions. But, ouch. Yeah. So, without trying to really shame you. Let them have it. Without really trying to say it's all your fault. It is actually all your fault. Which is okay. I'm sure, like, we're not looking at your allies, right? Because you can't control them, but in theory, it was all your fault. Because it started with you, and then die, and then lose the objective, and... It's okay. But you can't deny that one thing leads to another. I've thrown more games than I can count. And that's why I know. That's a very good leap. Nice. Yes, very good. I was hoping you would do that. Cancel the whirlwind or end it. Slam Lily. Very good. Let's see. You're level 13 and you have a pick. I think you just go for Life Funnel. They do have two interrupts with a Nubarak. Oh, Crit Weave, Burrow Charge and Impale. But that's about it. So I think Life Funnel here will be great. And I do think you'll take it. Because you've been taking whirlwind build. Well, let's see. You go Life Funnel, great. Good choice. I think that's not your fault because he got pushed by Lucio. Slam him. Nice. Okay, very nice. Good defense. I think at this point, yeah, you get this, you go get the impalers. At the bottom. Very good. Doesn't matter if you show, you've got map control anyway. So you guys are looking pretty good here.
A proud victory.
All right. You're gonna want to wait till she slows, he slows, and maybe he bolts. Spear is the hardest to hit of all of your abilities. So wait with your spear until someone else does something first. You do hit it. Very good. It was kind of simultaneous with bolt. The whirlwind, though. Lol. Okay. In this case, since Nazebo is dead and the five of you are here with impalers, if I were you, I would ping the tower. There is a very high likelihood that all of you would listen if you make the call. And it's the right call. All right, this is a case of under-maximizing, under-utilizing your massive advantage. Positionally, map pressure-wise, minimap-wise, you see Artanis is here. Death-wise, Nazebo is dead. Hero level-wise, it's equal. Every reason says you need to take these two towers out. To open up the map so that later, when you have a Punisher at bot, it represents a keep kill. And that's what wins games. The pressure. Instead, you get this, you get the fort, it's nice, but you would have always gotten this after getting this. Two towers, and then you ping retreat. Okay, you get the fort, it's all good. I'm not saying you're in a bad spot, you just could have been better off. Okay, you get the objective. Alright. I won't comment on that. Very nice interrupt on Lily with the spear. Great damage on her. You slam her. Very good, very good. You're still pretty healthy. You're going for a noob. Now you need to go back. This is great. You've got more skeletons. Lily is dead. But what you guys need is time. Very nice spear on the Nubarak, man. Very solid on the skill shots. Merlin will die, though. That's a pity. And it gets him closer to 16. Very good, very good. Now, back off. Tap fountain, back off, regroup and heal. You've got Lucio, but all of you are 20% life. Although you are 5 versus 2, you do need to heal. There is a fringe situation where one or more of you die, even though you're 4v2. If you heal up first, you also have the power to get the shrine still. They have 4 skeletons. There's no way they're going to take it from you. In fact, I would say all of you tap, clear the minion wave, then go to the objective. Instead, you nearly died. 4 versus 2. That would have you would have never lived it down. You didn't die, but it doesn't mean it was right. Over chasing, ping him back. Back. This is useless. It's a waste of time and resources, mana, and so on. So you get the objective, and now. Nice spear and leap. Yeah, hey, I'm liking your leap a lot, although I felt it was not the right choice and it's not as good late game. You're getting a lot out of it. Your spears are super on point, dude. You got Nazebo. Oh yeah. Great. All right, good job, guys. You get 2 more follow-up kills. The Punisher's pushing. Murden is split soaking. This is very well played. You're not pushing with the Punisher. That is the only point here. Very good. Nice. Using Whirlwind to go through him, get on this other side, body block him, and then get some more slams in. Very heads up play. A lot of damage on their keeps. You're 2 levels ahead now. I'm just starting to think... Oh yeah, and by the way, you took Stone Skin. I think it's a good choice. You could go Stone Skin or No Escape, both would be good, but I think this one is even better. Because you got Leap, so you need a lot of Burst Protect right afterwards. Ooh, not sure I agree with that one. Not only are you going to take a keep shot and get slowed, but you also start the fight when you've basically got 3 lanes pushing. Let's talk about what if we don't. Let's say you stand here and you threaten and engage. Now they are forced to stand there in a Western shootout. The 5 of you, the 5 of them. You're close to level 20. Once you get 20, your advantage is insane. The entire map is blue. So in fact, if there was one way for the opponent to make a comeback, it would be to force a fight ASAP on their terms. And you've given it to them. So you can win this fight, you can lose it, you can break even. But everything is worse than just staying here. Except if you get 4 kills and a keep. And you could have saved your leap and still do a fight under better terms. But just waiting, this is going to kill the wall, this is going to kill the wall. Greetings, friend. You're in a 99% win situation. Still, you're probably not going to pay for it. Maybe you are. Ah. Oh. This is the moment where Jackson knew. He fruited up. Yeah. If there was one moment that the game was thrown. Yeah, well, you know it. It's fun. It's good. It's very mature of you to admit it. Sometimes people will gang up on you and take advantage of your being nice. But at least you've put it out there and say, I know, that was bad. You're allowed to make mistakes. And everyone makes plenty. Wait, what did Nazebo die to? I don't know what. I think you guys can still engage. I think that's good. Nice leap. Oh my god, you wrecked them! You interrupted the jugs. You got kills. Okay, fantastic. Let me tell you what should happen. You're 5 versus 1, and the replay still lasts 10 minutes more, which is pretty much impossible. If you or any of the 5 of you ping midkeep or ping core, the game is over, guaranteed. Lily does not have the DPS to stop you. But here's what's going to happen. The 5 of you are going to kill the Punisher, because that's what you do. But in doing so, you have taken a 100% win situation. Murden got it, but he didn't ping. You've taken a 100% win situation to, I don't know what's going to happen later. So I would say your micro and your battle awareness, it got better even as the game went on. You were very objective focused in the first 2 objectives. But as the game went on, I was extremely impressed by your leaps and your spears. If there was one thing, and just one, from all the things I've mentioned to improve, it would be not to be authoritative, but to be a leader. Don't be afraid of someone saying, oh, you always want to be in charge. It just takes a ping sometimes to make a call, and as soon as you make it, the team will be like, oh yeah, of course, what are we doing? It's 20 versus 18, 5 versus 1, it's over. If you say, ping core, ping core, and you say, end. Everyone will realize it's the right choice. And you know what? If even 2 people had listened to you, Rag and Jaina, also still over. That's the level of comfort you guys had there. And this is very common at the mid to lower levels, because people maybe are afraid to make a call, maybe you don't think about it, you follow automatism. You've got Ignore Pain, it's a good level 20. And it's just a pity, because this game was won 4 times over already. So you did good to turn on Hardened Shield, but what you really should have done as well is turn on Whirlwind to increase your movement speed, gain healing during your Hardened Shield. And also you turned both on at the same time, which you should always try to avoid. It doesn't matter which one you use first, well it matters, but like if you're gonna do it one way, you can turn on one or the other. But this stone skin that is still there has now been wasted because you subtracted damage from your stone skin with Hardened Shield rather than subtracting damage from your HP. And subtracting damage, of course, is HP. It's healing. So it's probably just like panic, you click both, but you really want to use them in sequence. Leap away! Okay. Nice job trying to peel for your team as well. Good job. This is where you just, this is the most obvious place for you guys to go, which also makes it, in theory, the most risky. You can kill Falstad here. But oh, wow. Wow. You killed Falstad. Good job. All right. Okay. Very nice to use. You're very comfortable on Sonya. You use Whirlwind to get away even when there's nothing to heal on, just because you know it gives movement speed. You also do the pings now on Meriden. You learn from that. You know it's a bad choice, so you do the pings. Very good. And that's what you should have done at that bot camp as well. You go for the clears. It's good. Now, are you guys capable of stealing it back? I think yes. You're all here. So let's go. You still got a buffer. Not fond of you opening with the leap. I don't think it was important for you to interrupt fast here. Keeping in mind that they have Ravenous and Jokes, it's very important for you to save that. So I understand you felt like it was very important to start quickly because they got skeletons. But again, they have 23. I don't think the Punisher is going to determine this game. I think the team fight. So would have liked you to save it. And now you're in a situation where it's just got Jokes. You need to hit your spear. And you've now used a number of heroic. Oh, the split. Run! Meriden is a bit too ham. But it's still fine, because you've zoned him out. And you're now getting equal skeletons, so it's all good. But the one I'm worried about is Ravenous. Soon. Oh, you know what? You were very close to interrupting Hinterlands here. Nice, Nazebo, but everyone's ignoring him. Yeah. Ah, this one hurts. Of course, I can always say what could have been done better.
Greetings, friend.
That don't mean it was all your fault. But the whole team fight was a bit of a mess. These are the fights that are truly 50-50. You're 5, they're 5. Things happen, you do things right, you do things wrong, so do they, so do you. Doesn't matter, right? It's the fights where you had a clear advantage and a window to end the game and win. Those, I think, you have the best advantage in. But we fight on, and I think at this moment onwards, there's not much analysis value anymore. It's just like, is there anything obvious in terms of decisions? Because the micro-macro here, you're never going to remember a thing about what I say, like, at this stage. At this stage, it's a freaking... Bloodbath, well done. You speared a foul study, was vastly out of position. Of course, no one ever frees you. My Arag is helping. Okay. You can probably leap on Lily here and kill her. Very nice. Good job. You spear her. Hey, nice spear. This is where you use Ignore Pain and no Stone Skin yet. You use both at the same time again. And a bit late. Oh my god, run! Woo! Oh my god, that was close. Anyway, you guys defended, good job. And the game is getting to the end. 4 minutes. Yeah, Jaina went for Cold Snap. Better to go for Ice Block, but okay. That's, again, not his choice. Okay, mount up. This is where you mount. And then you get past him, you land the... Anyway, great job. You get the leap, you get the kill. And then you go get their camp. It's good, I like it. It's the obvious place for them to be, right? So you should go there. If Jaina didn't do this, you might get keep damage. But I would say a team fight is more important. Wow. Oh no! Alright, you're fine. Okay. Only lose one is okay. There's negative map pressure. They have a Fallen Bruiser. And you're 4v5. Center ring explode hype? I've never seen it. Yeah, he used it in sequence the other time. Okay, nice. You hit it on Nazebo. By the way, what's his 13? Ice Block. Oh, the leap. You really needed that against Lily. But look at that healing. It's insane. Okay, you started hitting Artanis. I guess it's your version of peeling. But you're 3v5. I think at this point, just leave. give the objective and try to save whomever you can. No, Jaina, why did you hit him once? Just run. All right, your ignore pain is late. Whirlwind, maybe you will live. Okay, your ignore pain was a little late. And then if you remember, it's the second time that you run away with ignore pain, but no whirlwind. It's you're very comfortable in Sonya, and you do it all the time, except during the times where you feel most stressed. Which makes sense, because during stress we forget, you know, all kinds of things. And so just try to practice that, even if you're in the midst of everyone, just try to roll in as well. It's very possible you guys lose the game here. Not much she can do about that. You lost Jaina before it got to the core. The thing to do is to pull it to the mid key. But yeah, I think it's over. It's a pity. This game is both a loss and a win. You could have won three times, but you lost. It means there's a lot to learn, but you don't need to feel too bad because you did a lot of things really well. But they should have had less than three keeps. No? Yes. MVP. No, this wasn't. It was a good game. It was.
Epic.
Yeah. GG. Thanks for the replay submission. Well played. And work on some of those ping decisions to recognize when you can end it. Nice, Jainabot! So sick. Jaina bot with the sick Ring of Frost.